Dr. Richard Jackson and audio-supported reading in action. New tools increase proficiency.
I think that the major point today with audio-supported reading is that we have a strong foundation for teaching children to learn to read using large print and using optical devices. And then we have another pedagogy that teaches students to learn through listening. What we haven't done is develop a curriculum that will integrate the learning through listening with the learning to read either in Braille or in print. We need an integrated system that will directly teach audio-supported reading.
Dr. Richard Jackson discusses the challenges of reading without audio support.
I learned to read using large print books. So it really wasn't until well into my career that I discovered the power of using technology to support my own reading. And I began with screen magnification that eliminated the need for large print and optical reading devices. So in my case, I read at somewhere between 150 and 175 words per minute under these conditions of magnification. To give you a sense of what that compares to, a typically seeing high school senior reads on average 300 words per minute. Reading fluency also has a relationship with reading comprehension. So if one reads very slowly, very disfluently, it's more challenging to process the information contained in the text. Reduced vision requires that you have to move your eyes to track along the line, and you have to move your head, and you have to get close to the magnified image. And if you add the speech to that, you're able to pay less attention to the visual information and more attention to the auditory information so that you're moving at a much faster rate. When I first experienced auditory supported reading, I was reading at print at 175 words per minute, and then when I increased the speech rate and listened at the same time, my fluency went up to 400 words per minute.
New technologies are essential for audio-supported reading and make it possible to dramatically increase reading fluency.
I'm using an application called Zoom Text that allows me to take a digital file, any digital file, and magnify it on screen and listen to it at the same time. So if I'm working with a document that is very cumbersome and difficult to comprehend, I might pay more attention to the visual aspect of what's being presented, so I'm slowing down the presentation. But if I'm working with documents that are very familiar or documents that I'm reviewing, I'm paying much more attention to the speech and able to really fly through the document.
Dr. Jackson discusses how he can read anywhere now using audio-supported reading on mobile devices.
I've never been able to use a smartphone because I have extremely low vision. And with the advent of these Android larger screen phones, I can use my technique for reading in a mobile environment. So I can do what I call audio-supported reading. I have a document opened here on the screen, and this device allows me to listen to the document being read aloud. At the same time, I can look at the document using my vision. What I've done with my iPad is to download a set of books and articles and documents that can be accessed using this wonderful application called Voice Dream Reader. Voice Dream Reader is set up with my preferences right now. And what I really prefer to do is to read visually and listen at the same time.
When I'm doing audio supported reading, if I mishear something, I can see what was spoken. And if I don't see something, then I picked it up with the audio portion.
What we really need is to bring this pedagogy into school settings so that kids early on are leveraging the technology that's available today and helping them become far more fluent in their reading and access the curriculum to a much greater extent than they have in the past.